I invite you to join with me in prayer. Father, today we bow before you and we just give thanks for the life of Miss Elsie Stephanie. And we groan and we mourn, and we know that you are present. We know that your words say, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. Lord, today we ask for the promise of the Holy Spirit to comfort. For you said yourself, blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. So we pray for that for Miss Elsie's family and friends and all those that have been impacted by this loss. And yet at the same time, give us hope. The hope of the truth of what your word tells us. We pray all of that now in Jesus' name. Amen.
He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. May this song and the readings of the words add some comfort or solace to Elsie's family and friends. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Will I be able to speak it all? I can only reflection. Ms. Elsie F. Stephanie, daughter of Mike and Ciala Stephanie, was born on November 11, 1962 in Honolulu, Hawaii. Elsie received her bachelor's degree in business management from Hawaii Pacific University and a master's degree in accounting information systems from Strayer University. Elsie entered the government services with the U.S. Air Force in December of 1986. From there, she worked in various U.S. Army organizations, including assignments to Washington, D.C., Denver, Colorado, Germany, and deployments to Afghanistan in support of Operation Freedom Sentinel. Elsie earned the reputation of a trusted colleague and a friend who would do whatever was needed to ensure her needs of her supervisor and her coworkers were met. Her final position was an assignment with the U.S. Army Materiel Command as the Chief of the Auto Readiness Division for the Resource Management Directorate. Elsie was a loving woman, not just to her family, but to anybody that she ever encountered. She loved traveling to see new and different sights and experiences. However, her greatest joy is spending time with her family and her close friends. Her awards include the Commander's Award for Civilian Service and the Superior Civilian Service Award. She was a certified defense financial manager and a member of the American Society of Military Comptrollers. Elsie leaves to cherish her memories, her parents, Mike and Ciala Stephanie, her beloved children, Michael Stephanie and his wife, Seema, and Katrina Amadeus, her sister, Flossie Stephanie, Sina Pruder, and Alina Stephanie, her brother James Stephanie, and her nephew Daniel Pruder. Stephanie will always be in our hearts and our memories. God bless you all.
Thank you for joining us. We're here because we loved Elsie, and Elsie loved us. I have a way about me that is, I have a humorous thread through me. That's the way that I hide my disappointment, but it's the way that I hide grief and sorrow also. So I'm hoping to get through this. This was real easy last night, okay? But it may not be today. I may have to come down to you, Katrina, and get some of those tissues, okay? But let me talk a little bit about as far as what Katrina meant to us. Okay, it's not about what she meant to me. In preparing for this, what I did was I brought in individuals that had worked with Katrina, I'm sorry, with Elsie, and asked for them to tell me some of the stories about what the characteristics were that they remember about Elsie. There's a young man that we have worked for us by the name of Jared Terry. And Jared came into the Army as an intern, and he was there with Elsie. Elsie was his supervisor in his first assignment as far as within the Army. So, and Jared has that long-lasting time as far as the person that he met that came into, when he came into the Army, that made that particular impact. And what he told me about her was the way that she cared, the way that she was a teacher, the way that she was a leader that helped build that particular foundation as far as what he is today. He has a great career. And when we were there in Denver, he was one of the individuals that was right there in the waiting room to find out as far as how Elsie was doing. I went to another member, Herman Henry, and asked Herman what he knew. Herman told me, he says it was the way that she worked with the team. She was always about the team, always building. That there was that particular side as far as it was no nonsense. That she trusted individuals to do their work, she made the work assignments, and then went forward and allowed them to do it. spoke with another individual by the name of Jay Shaw. And Jay, he pointed out, yes, Jay is a little bit robotic and a bit as far as the way that he categorizes things. But he indicated she was always professional in everything that she did. She was no nonsense. She would make a duty assignment and then allow individuals the freedom in order to exercise and move forward as far as to get the work done. She was willing to take the risk as far as if something would in fact go wrong, but she was also willing to praise when things went right. I asked another individual, Mike Engelmeyer. Mike Engelmeyer had a little bit of a humorous story about what had happened to him and with Elsie. Mike had been working on a program that required reconciliation work. It's called the Joint Reconciliation Program. And he had the program for a while and was being transferred to someone else. And he had his eyes on a particular job that he wanted. That was working with anti-deficiency violations, those types of things as far as where individuals perhaps spend money the wrong way or spend more money than what they have. And he was going to be assigned that job. He was assigned that job, okay? So he thought that he had really gotten over. Well, about that same time, Elsie was being reassigned to our GFEDS organization. That's the General Fund Enterprise System. It's a large accounting system is what GFEDS is. So she was being assigned to that, but this was just being deployed, and it was not considered to be a good job. And when she was offering Mike this job as far as with the anti-deficiency violations, she says, how do you feel about that? Are you okay with that? And Mike said, oh, yes, I'm okay with it. I says, if I had the choice between GFIBs and anti-deficiency violations, I would take the anti-deficiency violations. Okay. Well, in the wit that Elsie had, she says, careful. She says, I couldn't find you a job in GFIBs. I'm going to be a little bit brave here on this last story. And this was one because it just shows the character and the love and that Elsie felt and the way that she was accepted by her teammates and her friends. On the day of the tragedy, Elsie went out to lunch with her friends. And during the course of that lunchtime, they were talking about one of her dear friends, Anitra Morrison here. Anitra Morrison is one that Anitra and Elsie frequently talked about going into business together. But they were talking about Anitra and Anitra's recent marriage. And so it came up for her, well, why would Anitra want to get married at this stage of her life? And Elsie offered the answer. She says, it must be the sex. the table cracked up. They broke out in laughter as far as Elsie said. Elsie had that way about her, is that she had a dry sense of humor, but a wit, but comments that could absolutely shock you. Those are the types of things that we loved about Elsie. Thank you.
For those of you that don't know me, I'm Sue Goodyear, and I'm the representing the Army Materiel Command and our GA today. As most of you know, Elsie was part of our family for the last 9 months as our Chief of Audit Readiness. And so I wanted to come here today to honor her and to talk to you about some of the things similar to what Mr. Miller just said. She volunteered to take on this adventure, not only the job, but moving south, moving to Alabama, she wanted to learn a little bit about the South, but if that wasn't enough adventure for her, she took on the toughest job we had. She did the job at the work. She was the right person at the right time for the right thing, at least for me, it